Good morning, everyone. Afreilich in Shushan Purim, the day after our Purim in Yerushalayim Yakadish, in the land of Israel, in Jerusalem. They are celebrating Purim as we speak, going into the Shabbos, and we ourselves are coming off of a beautiful, uplifting, inspiring, mesmerizing Purim that's now going to bring us into a beautiful Shabbos Kadish. And the Chazal speak about the following idea, that when you have a double year of Adar Aleph and Sheni, which we did not have this year, but the Gemara asks, in which month do we celebrate Purim? Do we celebrate Purim the first Adar? We're so excited for Purim to come, so we want to do it Zrizim Magdim B'mitzvahs. People that are love mitzvahs are alacritous to do that quickly. Or do we wait until the second month of Adar? And the Gemara answers, we do it in the second month of Adar. Why? Because we want to connect the Geula, the redemption of Purim, to the Geula of Mitzrayim, to the redemption of our exodus from Egypt when we're coming into the Yom Tov of Pesach. And the explanation is the following idea, that on Purim we know that Klal Yisrael was saved. We were rescued from the hands of Haman, from this wicked man who was trying to destroy us and exterminate us. That's one level of the redemption that took place. But the second level of this great geula, the redemption that which took place for everybody yesterday in Purim, is just as we know that nichnas yayin, that when the wine goes into a person, yotz asayid, the secrets of that human being, of that individual, they reveal themselves. That means that the heilige neshama, the beautiful soul that a person was given by HaKadosh Baruch Hu, that all year long is protected with our fences that are up, to hold ourselves back from really expressing the beauty of that neshama that's inside of us. When the wine of Purim goes inside, it has the koyach, it has the power and the ability to bring out the beauty and the reinkeit, the purity of the neshama that sits inside and dwells bekirbay within each and every one of Klal Yisrael. This itself is a geula, is a redemption, is a revelation of the most spiritual, sublime possibilities in a person's life. When a person frees themselves of all of the chains and the shackles that are holding back their neshama from achieving what it would like to in this world, there is no greater geula redemption than that. Say Chazal, the sages tell us, when do we make Purim? In a year where it's a double Adar, we make it in the second one. Why? Because we want to connect the geula, the redemption which took place on Purim, which was just yesterday when our neshamas were let free, possibly for the first time, maybe since Yom Kippur, we just could express ourselves and see the beauty of what's inside of us and become ruchni, become more spiritual through the wine, through the eating, through the singing, through the dancing. Our neshama is able to reach a level that which is not known throughout the year. Now we're connecting it to the geula, the redemption of Yetzias Mitzrayim, of when Klal Yisrael found itself living in Mitzrayim in Egypt on the 49th level of Tumah, of impurity. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu saw deep down inside of our hearts that we're still Yidden, we're still the Jewish people. And we understand the preciousness of our neshama and our time here in this world. And we cried out to HaKadosh Baruch Hu that He should save us and bring us to a better place than being immersed inside of the lost land of Mitzrayim, of Egypt over there. Comes along Moshe Rabbeinu as the Moshiach, as the Savior and the Messenger for Klal Yisrael. And He comes and He does a miracle which HaKadosh Baruch Hu Himself elevated and raised us up to a madrega, to a level where we were worthy of Geulas Mitzrayim, of the exodus from Egypt, not just the physical exodus of the Jewish people escaping and leaving the land, but more importantly, it was a ruchni, a spiritual geula redemption for each and every one of Klal Yisrael. So we now have 30 days to keep the geula of Purim, the redemption of our neshamas, the expression of the beauty and the purity inside each and every one of our neshamas here in this world. 30 days to prepare ourselves now for Pesach, in which we're going to see how Klal Yisrael goes free. They go free from our enemies, we go free from the pressures of the world, we go free from the ideologies that are against what it says inside of the Torah, and we become a nation that is committed with all of our hearts and all of our souls and all of our might, we're committed to the Ribbono Shel Olam, the Goal Yisrael, the one that redeems the Jewish people. Wishing everybody a Freilich and Shushan Purim. May we be zeicher to hold on to the koichais, the tremendous powers and strengths and elevations and inspiration that we received yesterday, carry it with us into a beautiful Shabbos Kodesh, and that itself will be the kivun, that will be the thing that is going to give us the proper direction to get us ready for Pesach, and then Pesach will take it into a whole new madrega, a whole new level of geula, redemption of the neshama. From everybody here at Makor HaChaim, we are wishing you a wonderful day.